fans, and welcome to Lincoln County High School in Buddy Buffett Field. This is Bruce Beggs along with Kenny Adair, Greg Norman, Layton Taylor, Jim McKinney, and Ernie Doss. And we'll be bringing you this exciting football matchup between the Lincoln County Red Devils and the GMC Bulldogs. We see our team captains on the field.
They are number 1, Will Scoosby. Number 62, Garrett Matthews. Number 60, Johnny Catorius Jones. And for the Bulldogs, we have number 21, Zach Seagraves. Number 79. Boy, this is going to be a real challenge. Michael Eubanks, number 17.
Matt Harrison.
Good going, Layton. And number 7 is Mick Melder. It would be so much easier if we had these rosters, whoever printed them, if we had them in numerical order.
Whoever printed them.
I believe he's I forget who it was.
Well, who won the toss or whatever? I mean, I was busy looking for names and numbers. Somebody tell me what happened.
Did we get the captains, Will Scoosby?
Yeah, we want to know who's going to receive the ball.
Well, I got the middle of the team here.
Well, one team is going to kick off and the other one's going to receive.
That's for sure.
Who won, Ernie? Did you pay it? Did you get it while I was looking all these numbers up?
I didn't. I was looking off in the wild blue yonder.
I tell you what, I'm on the field with his team in his hands, but I ain't got a clue.
Somebody on the sidelines is supposed to be keeping up.
Well, I did the first time before Bruce said we had a problem.
The coin twice just because we messed up. Yeah, that's a first. I wonder if they'll start over again.
Please, Captain. Yeah, just redo that ball game down there since I left one box. It's on the van.
You know the deal wasn't too big. It was just that one cable.
Yeah,
that's what had about it.
But I got a remedy for that.
Yeah, we got two of them now.
Yep.
One in each box.
All right.
I'm 89 tall.
Number two. Help, Lee.
Total disaster here. Jamaris Walls. And number 15, I believe it is.
I take a vow.
I just throw mine away. I ain't going to look no more.
There ain't no 15 on there.
It may be 12. I don't know.
When the ball was kicking off, he's in it. He got on.
Tell you what.
Where we at, y'all?
At the 6-yard line.
6-yard line.
That was number 12. He fumbled around and
just fell on the ball.
Under heavy pressure by the Red Devil kickoff team. Now to start GMC
ball game.
11:54 left to go in the first quarter. Just getting underway on the opening kickoff still.
Yeah, he kind of reminded me of the way we look when we trying to plug all these wires and stuff in. Bumbling around.
You must have a rattle in your pocket or something, though.
What do you mean?
All right, they going to come out here and open it up. Shotgun. Going to send motion to the right. Straight drop.
Oh,
pass almost at the 21-yard line by number 12, Alex Ellis. He had a guy open, though. Number 8 had broken open in the flats. It did. Second down, 10 upcoming. Ball on about the, I don't believe it's quite to the 6.
Yes, just touching it.
Quarterback's going to be under center this time. Still got 4 wideouts. 1 in the backfield. Straight drop back. Pass on the slant. Complete. Out close to the first down.
All them arms. It's short, Greg.
Going to be third down, about a yard short. Ball pass complete right at about the 14.
Yeah, he's got to make, it's actually close to 2. He's got to get to the
about the 15
and the 16, and it's just over the 14.
Started here. Clock down 11:17. Still scoreless. Got 3 wideouts this time. Out backfield behind the quarterback. Hand off right up the middle, and he is met with a big welcome to Buddy Buffett Field by number 61, Ronnell Ferguson.
He's been welcoming a lot of folks lately.
He has. Fourth down and about 2 now. Loss of 1 on the play. See number 44 kind of gimp-legged. Dancing around, trying to get the blood flowing again. Fourth down, 2. Send number 8. Cody Bounds, that's on the front page of my roster. He's right up at the top. I can find him easy. Number 12, Ellis back deep.
kick's going to go out of bounds. Well, it's going to bounce up. A punt that may have could have been returned.
What about the 45?
Going to be down at about the 44 and a half yard line. Well, Lincoln County will take over first and 10. 10:24 left to go in the first. Still scoreless.
I don't know if anybody at home knows, but the GMC hadn't had the best of years this year. They are coming in here with the big goose egg.
They hadn't won a game.
They hadn't won a game.
I didn't think they had.
I was looking at the history of it. They'd had many of those.
Got number one Goosby wide right. Number 26 Green.
They fight the
ramble
the
ball
kid.
For about seven. Going to bring up second down at about three. Good gain on first down. Red Devil stands over there just full of Red Devil, red and white. Shotgun number 14 Goldman. Got two wide right, two in the backfield with him. Straight drop. Back blitz under heavy pressure, gets it out there complete to number 26 Green, and he dances around, rambles down close to the 20, where it'll be first and 10 Red Devils.
We got a new producer up here in the booth with us tonight. He wants our director.
I mean, he got here right at kickoff.
Yeah.
That's always good. First and 10, Red Devil. Ball on the 22. We've done this.
He's good at that. Directing. I'm trying to.
Two wides wide left, one to the right. Going to roll out and throw back to number one, Will Scoosby. And he almost makes the first man miss. Big number 60, Johnny Carr, about there trying to lay a block for him. Gain of about five, maybe five and a half. Bring up second down at about five.
I can tell you one thing. I believe they got that PA dial in this week.
Yeah, it sounds good.
It sounded good.
It says it's wall to wall and three top tall.
Getting out all over town, ain't it? Yep. Second down about four. Gain of six on the last pass play. Going to send Wilkes over here wide left by himself. A tee back field.
Got a timeout.
And the Red Devils are called timeout. Looking at a second down and about four to go. 8:32 left to go in the opening quarter. Still scoreless.
Greg, while we got this timeout, we want to remind our viewers about some upcoming events in our community. We got coming up on November the 24th, a turkey shoot. That'll be at the American Legion. That's sponsored by the Sons of the American Revolution.
Is that on the side of the roof?
Sons of the American Legion. I don't know, it's on November the 24th, whatever day that is, y'all look that up.
Somebody that ain't got nothing to do could look that up.
Yeah. That's it starts at 7 o'clock and it goes until 10 p.m. And they will have food there, and that's always good. And I've been to those turkey shoots and it's a lot of fun. You want to take your family out to that?
Yeah,
and I went to well, a turkey or a ham or something for Thanksgiving.
They have all kinds
day
of
stuff,
sides of bacon.
Yeah,
money.
I mean, they have
pork chops.
A lot of good things.
Yeah, yeah. Packages of pork chops, chicken. They have boo-coodles and stuff. All right, we're back now on the ball. Handoff number 25, Middlebrooks, out of the shotgun. He's going to ramble around the right side.
Oh, we got some flags. Two of them coming in.
Was it a face mask, Kenny, or blocking the back?
I couldn't tell.
Where are you at?
I'm in the corner of the end zone trying to get
I don't imagine you could see it from down there.
Greg, I can't see it over the cheerleaders. And over all these cameras here, trying to get a view of it, buddy.
You ain't got to get short with me.
I am. I'm going to get short. You're going to get short when I pound on that head.
Fire away, big boy.
I think it was called against Lincoln County.
Yeah, I think it was going to be a block
sure
in the back.
It is, but
is it a block in the back or holding? I don't know.
I think it was holding from what I saw. Have we got the mic on the official tonight?
Did you get over here in time to get it on him?
I didn't mess with it no more. I'm not sure if we mic the official tonight or not. I think he's got
signal. Did he ever
it's on
signal?
His side. It's on him. Here he goes.
Hold him.
Oh, that works good. Uh-oh.
Yeah, that wasn't good.
We told him he can't. He's got to face away from. He's got to turn his shoulder in some.
What he's got to do is look at you every time, Ernie, and you can tell us what the call is.
When he's on the other end of the field, he'll be fine, but down here.
Second down, 9 to go. Handoff. Around the left side.
26, is it?
I believe it's one of the greens. Number 27, I believe, you Fabian.
One of the Green brothers.
Third down, less than a yard to go.
Third down, 1 upcoming. Clock going to be down under 8 minutes with the snap of the ball.
It ain't got a yard to go.
Wilkes over here wide. Double wing, motion left. Handoff, number 26.
He's just
dragging Bulldogs with him. Down close to the 5-yard line where it'll be first and goal.
He dragged about three of the soldiers across the line. Then.
Jamarin Green carrying the mail down at that time. Ball just across the 5, about the 5.5. Well, it'll be first and goal with 7:35 left to go. Got Goosby wide left again. Let's see if they throw him the slant this time. Nope, handoff off the right side. Number 25, Middlebrook.
Touchdown, Red Devils.
Number 25, A.G. Middlebrook's on about a 6-yard touchdown run. 7:19 left to go. In the opening quarter, Red Devils up 6-0. Looking for the PAT. Number 18, Bo Reed to do the holding. While number 89, Tarver, will do the kicking. Good snap, good hold.
Good kick.
Good
kick.
Top of the building.
And over the...
That went over, didn't it?
Yeah. I believe it did go on over the gym. Red Devils take an early 7-0 lead with 7:19 left to go in the opening quarter. You got any upcoming events you want to remind us
of?
Yeah,
we want to remind our viewers about Pioneer Day coming up on November the 17th. That'll be at the Historical Park, and that's a great day to take your family out for a lot of fun and food. They have all of those buildings that they have, the grist mill, the sawmill, the blacksmith shop, the doctor's office,
black eyed peas.
Oh, yeah, they have a lot of food there.
Turnip greens.
They even have some
yum.
Also want to remind our viewers about the first Saturday we'll have our Holidays in Old Lincolntown Festival and parade. It'll be in the evening this time. You want to be sure and call the Welcome Center 359-7970 and get more information on that.
Number 89, Tarver, tees it up at the 40.
Good kick.
Kicks it high and deep. Ball going to be taken at about the 2-yard line by number 2.
Ooh, what a good hit.
Immediately at the 15-yard line by a host of Red Devils. Who's the first one down there, Kenny? Obviously some audio difficulties. Obviously.
I had just had a News 12 guy hand me a business card after could we call him with the final score. I bet he's moving on.
Well, that'd be your job, Kenny. Make sure you call it.
First and 10, Bulldogs. Ball spotted on about the 12-yard line. They're going to come back out here with 4 wide out. Shotgun again. Straight drop back.
Got a flag.
Play going to be blown dead.
They got a couple pretty big boys on the grid.
Yeah, they got number 79, but number 40, Tony Wells, just run right straight dead over him.
But they look big, but when you look at Ron Allen crew, goodness.
Number Number 79 is Michael Eubank, 6'1", 280, Kenny.
He's 6'1", 280?
Yep. Pretty good sized kid. Shotgun again, four wide outs. Looking at a first and five. Good snap. Quick pass.
Oh, off the hands.
In and out of the hands of number 17. Number 12, Alex Ellis over there with the coverage on the play.
He's got a quick release, don't he, Greg?
Yeah, he does. Bulldogs will be looking at a second and five. Ball on the 22-yard line. Clock stopped at 7:04. Red Devil still got a 7-0 lead. Same set again. Straight drop back. He lets it go quick out in the flats, and I believe he might have lost a yard.
He did. Let's see where he spots him. It's definitely at the line.
Good coverage on the play by number eight, Franklin Sherman.
Yeah, he marked him a yard back where he was.
Third down, about five and a half, maybe six.
Greg, I forgot. Vernon told me to start with. I don't think I mentioned y'all that Carlos Thurston ain't going to play it all tonight. And he didn't cover
it.
Well,
that's good.
Know.
I see number 62, Garrett Matthews, in there playing a little linebacker. We done swapped a good many kids around tonight. Same set.
We're going to call a roughing. What are we going to call? Did he hit him late?
No, there ain't no way to hit him late.
Here he goes. No, we got a face mask. 5 yards against us.
Five-yard face mask. Still going to be short of the first down.
It's going to be about fourth and one.
With 6:15 left to go. Bulldogs are going to be faced with a fourth and short. And looks like they're going to opt to go for it. Unless they don't know us enough for the first down.
I see Butch flipped it back to third down.
That may be a 15th.
No, they it's moved. On the five. It's fourth down, ain't it? Now, Butch has flipped it back to third, but didn't we go through this last week? You can't have both the down and the... I don't know.
Yeah, that should be fourth down. Anyway, they got third down and less than a yard. Shotgun, four wideouts, heavy pressure, and he'll be sacked back to about the 20-yard line where it'll be fourth down. At about seven. And number 62, Garrett Matthews in there with heavy pressure. Along with number 40, Tony Wells. Number 72 of the Red Devils. Back there with big pressure as well to Travis Hurst. Fourth down and about seven upcoming. Red Devils will send number 12, Alex Ellis, back deep.
No, we might have jumped.
I think we did jump.
And it's going to be
I don't know. I believe, it's going to be long and fourth and one. I believe it may be a legal procedure. Nope, they're going to call all sides.
The only thing I saw was our guy fall over the line. It's going to be about one and a half, something like that.
Yeah, it's going to be about two.
All right. You want a job? Huh?
Well, you look and see where it's at.
This has been a little uncharacteristically sloppy.
It has. Well, there's just not a whole lot of... Red Devil's more or less waiting to see who wins game.
He got it away and kicking away.
If it'll bounce back, pick it up, Alex. Pick it up. Don't let it go out of bounds. Pick it up.
He got a GMC.
He almost fumbled it on the pickup. Down at about the 32-yard line where the Red Devils will take over first and 10. Go back on offense with 5:17 left to go in the opening quarter. Red Devils still holding a 7-0 lead. See if he lets Austin add out here again. You know, you hate to say anything really, but as bad as the game was last week, the 2-minute offense didn't really look that bad, did it? I guess I'm on here by myself again.
No, it
shotgun,
didn't look, it didn't
four
look
wideouts, handoff, number 26, Green, and he breaks loose out across the 50, finally drug down to about the 48 of GMC.
I'm trying to find the Twiggs County score.
Well, who in the world? I thought we had somebody on the internet.
You looking at them?
First and 10, Red Devils. Ball spotted right on the 47. We got number 70, Michael Newman, in that playing center. Giving Big Garrett a rest as he's playing some on defense. Shotgun, three wideouts. Gonna send Middlebrooks in motion. Hand off again, number 26, Green. He rambles forward for about four, maybe five more. Ball gonna be spotted down about the 42 and a half. Well, they gonna move it to the 43, where it'll be second down and five. Second five, shotgun, four wideouts, all four of them in kind of tight. Bulldogs send heavy pressure. Little screen pass across the middle, complete to number 27, Green. And he is spinning and rambling down.
Where you at, Layton?
At about the 20.
I needed you on that one, buddy.
I'm still looking at them a bit.
He acts like, I guess Layton acts like Twiggs County and Wilkerson playing tonight or something, don't he? Ain't no interest in that game, is it?
I imagine it's more eyes focused there than it is anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
As far as Region 8A is concerned anyway.
And 5 and 6.
First and 10, ball spotted right on the 20. Handoff, number 25, Middlebrooks off tackle, and there he goes off to the races. He'll go in untouched on a 21-yard touchdown run. Number 25, A.G. Middlebrook. We have got to call his name a lot more in his high school career, I can tell you. 3:28 left to go. Red Devils move out to a 13-0 lead. Awaiting the point after. Who is that doing the snapping, Ernie? Can you get a number on it?
Hang on up.
Is it 15?
That's who was doing it last week, which is, what is it, Franklin Sherman? That is who it is.
No, number 15 will be Jones in there doing the long snap.
Okay.
I believe he may have been doing it. You know, that's something we failed to notice all year is who's been doing the long snapping.
He's been doing it for the last several games, number 15.
And been doing a good job. Bo Reed, number 18, does a good job of holding. And you just can't say enough about Vance's kicking. Although he did trick him last week with one. Not saying that it was bad, but just saying that it took him a while to tell whether it was good or not. It was one of them, I don't know, you call it.
Greg, you mentioned a while ago, we had something going on. The two-minute offense, I said all week, you know, then on the bus the other night, that last 2 minutes,
Austin
really looked calm, poised. The whole team
did. They hustled, you know, to the line of scrimmage.
We just didn't have but a minute and eight, you know, just run out of time.
3:28 left to go in the opening quarter. Red Devils up 14-0. Tarver got it teed up, hits it high. Not quite as deep this time, taking it about to 7. Well, he is hit hard. By number 42 of the Red Devils, Smith, hustling down there to make contact. Ball gonna be spotted at about the 21 yard, it's just across the 20, about the 20 and a half. Where it'll be first and 10, Bulldogs. Have a wide out wide each side. Two in the backfield behind the quarterback. He'll drop straight back.
Uh-oh.
And that's going to be picked off. Ain't going to be no good coming out of that. Down Red Devils. Number 27, Jamarin Green on a 21-yard interception.
I had to view that. There wasn't nobody in my way here. I saw that developing. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, I mean, that was. Looked kind of like that Lakeside play, didn't it? Like we had been practicing together with them and knew what they was going to do.
There you go. You know, I don't know if you watched it. I paused it, Greg. I was wondering, how in the world did the guy not open? Well, they had, I counted nine, you know, three linemen and then the rest of them, but there was two guys that were playing safety, it looked like. Way back, it wasn't in the view to start with. That's how they was able to cover it and intercept it.
Red Devils up by a score of 21-0 with 3:14 left to go here in the first quarter. Long first quarter hit. Beautiful Buddy Buffett Field.
Well, we got a second. You may notice that GMC has very few cheerleaders, and that's because GMC is going to the state cheerleading competition on tomorrow morning, as a matter of fact. Lincoln County unfortunately didn't make it. Aquinas and GMC are going, so I imagine their varsity cheerleaders have headed on down to Columbus, Georgia, where the state championships are going to be held.
You know, I hadn't noticed that, Ernie, but now that you say it, I see five cheerleaders here right in front of us.
And just when they came in, they all look young, so I'm just assuming that's the JV team.
Red Devils got a very good competition cheer squad, but just some injuries here late in the year at a time you really don't need them.
We were proud.
You never need an injury anyway.
All right, guys, here we go. I got me in contact. Wilkinson, 7 Tweeds, 0.
Oh, there you go.
There you go.
I guess I told him to
put that on the
stick
internet.
Stick with me tonight.
Number 89, Tarver, got it teed up. Kicks it high. Taking it about the 6-yard line. Hit by number 5, Jatoris Jones, and number 30, Major Elam. GMC in a hole again. Ball looks like it's going to be spotted at about the 23-yard line, 22 or 23. How much time left to go in the game, Kenny?
I will go back and ask him. It's Gene Frazier. I want to thank him for it. He said he's got somebody down there, a contact that's going to be calling him.
First and 10, Bulldogs. Quarterback under center, handoff on a delay. Number 10, Tavis McGee had a stop in the backfield, but running back able to slip the tackle. Run out a gain of about 9 yards, where it'll be second down and 1 to go. Best play of the night so far for the Bulldogs. Clock down to 2:30. Red Devils up 21-0. Quarterback under center got three wideouts, and I believe they're going to call timeout. GMC.
I didn't see a flag. Like right. They jumped in the center, snapped it, but obviously they called time before it all happened.
Want to thank some of our sponsors. Kenny and Roy Jeffco to Providence Ferry. And what did you say, Kenny? Was you saying that Kenny Jeffco?
Yes, we want everybody to think about him. Kenny's a good person to help us with our wireless headsets we got here. Been a supporter of us. He was working with the church, helping renovate a house this past weekend, and I don't know what he fell off of. He fell off of something. And he thought he broke a few ribs. He was in pain, and he finally went to the emergency room later. And long story short, over a few days, the pain wouldn't go away, got worse, and he went in the hospital. And the latest is he's had a surgery last night, and they removed 2 quarts of blood out of his out of the inside of him. He punctured his lung is actually what happened. The pain was coming from, and it was bleeding.
Good gracious.
He's on morphine drip right now.
Two wideouts. Out backfield. I believe he's going to finally have enough for a first down. That'll move the sticks. First and 10, Bulldogs. Yeah, we want to keep him, definitely keep him in your prayers. And if y'all have never seen Kenny Jeffco, if I ain't mistaken, he played college football at Clemson University.
He played a little over there, and he blew a knee out.
So that ought to tell you he ain't the average-sized person.
No, he's pretty good size.
Yes, sir, he's tough.
I met him. He's pretty good size.
High backfield again. Got 2 wideouts. Quarterback under center. Handoff. Last man through. And he is hammered Number 62, Garrett Matthews, in there with the initial lick.
And you
second down and about six to go. Clock running down here late in the first quarter, down to 1:38. Red Devils still up 21 to nothing. But GMC is putting together a little drive here. They done found something they like out of this I formation with the two wideouts.
They've been a long quarter.
Quarterback gonna drop, roll right to his right. Oh, ooh. Pass right through the hands of number 17. Number five, Jatoris Jones,
with slipped down, didn't he, Greg?
Yeah, with the coverage, and he slips down. That could have went for something, but definitely would have been a first down.
Yeah, look like me. If he hadn't slipped, he'd have either took a hard leak or he could have probably got to the ball first.
Pass right through the hands of number 17. And I wish I could find it on this roster. Matt Harrison. This is like putting a jigsaw puzzle together. And not one age is five and up either. Same set. Drop back, roll out again, number seven. He just lays it up this time for broke.
Yeah, dangerous, wasn't it?
Yeah.
He put it all in line.
He's lucky that didn't get picked off. He just running for his life and throws it up and hopes his man catches it. Pass intended again for number 17, Harrison. But it falls incomplete. Where they'll be faced with a fourth down and about six. Big punting situation coming up. And they've been punting away from number 12, Alex Ellis, all night. High snap. And he punts it away from him again.
We ought to put two guys back there.
And he picks it up at the 30. Got a wall set up. One man misses. He's rambling. Gets across midfield. Finally tackled at about the 47-yard line. Well, the Red Devils have it in Bulldog territory again, first and 10, with 54 and a half seconds left to go in the first quarter. I wonder if we score 30 points, will they go ahead and let the clock start running in the second quarter?
I don't know. This sure is a long quarter to any degree.
You know, if we already scored three times, if we'd have went for two all three times and made it one more, would have put us over the edge, wouldn't it?
There you go.
Shotgun. Four wide, good snap, good pickup on the block, pass over the middle, high for number one, Wilkes Goodman. Still a pass that he should catch. Big hit, I believe that's number two. Jamaris Walls with the lick on number one, Goodman, but he gets up and runs back to the huddle. Second and 10, 48.7 seconds. Austin got to get the ball down a little bit for your guy going across the center, going across the middle.
I'm gonna leave him up there open.
He's wide open again across the middle.
Oh.
Oh, what a catch
by Will Scoot.
Good job, number one, Will Scoot.
I hope, looks like Gil got that. That's
yes,
the,
sir. That was
the highlight of the year. That looked kind of like that Frank O'Hara's Immaculate Kids or something, didn't it? How in the world he come up with that?
I don't know how he did it, but it was a doggone. That's concentration's what that is. Mad because he missed the one before that, I can tell you. And why ain't the clock stopped on the first down? I guess he just wound it, maybe.
Did he trip initially or something? Because the pass wasn't that bad.
The pass was behind him. It was so far behind him, it hit number two right dead in the two. He wasn't expecting it. Shotgun, four wides again. Good pickup on the blitz.
Uh-oh. Guess as you say that, there's your 79, Greg.
Well, that was a coverage sack. Bulldogs had good coverage downfield. Clock going to expire right now. Red Devils up 21 to nothing at the beginning of the second quarter. We'll swap ends of the field.
And while we got this change of position on the ends of the field, we want to remind everybody that this game every week is brought to you by Lincoln County Chamber of Commerce with the help of Lincoln County Technology Department, headed up by Crawford Asbell. Also want to remind you that you can go on Lincoln County website, look at Lincoln County football. We've got two games posted right now. We're going to have more in the future. And also You can also see the highlight film from last year.
I also want to thank Wilkes Telephone, Jane Calloway and George Dyson at newz.net for the fast, high-speed internet hit provided to us at Buddy Buffett Field to keep up with all of the scores.
I also want to thank Goldman and Wingroves for all your clothing needs. Go to Goldman and Wingroves for these replica.
No, sir. This is the official wear.
Official wear of Lincoln County TV crew. We sporting our fleece pullovers.
I tell you what, they are very nice.
They are nice.
They are very warm. Nice.
As you're going to need them as the Red Devils go deep into the playoffs this year.
Just go by and see Michael and tell him you want one of the official jackets.
Lincoln County TV.
Of the TV broadcast.
Yeah, we got a new quarterback in, guys.
Number 18, Bo Reed's in now with the shotgun. Handoff number 25, Middlebrooks, trying to get off the left side.
Greg, I was going to say, I think what's happened, Austin was up on the sideline. I was hoping he wasn't hurt, but I think he got a chin strap problem. I think he broke his chin strap. They were trying to get another one hooked up.
Gain of about 4 on the play. Get back to the original line of scrimmage where it'll be third down about 10 and a half. Clock running, 11:27 left to go in the second quarter. Number 18, Reed, still in that quarterback, lines up in the shotgun. Got a wide out wide each side, two in the backfield with him.
Mm-hmm.
Snap gets by. Big loss on the play.
I couldn't tell whether that was bad
looks
snap
like
or.
Just coming in jitters. He tried to make the play, run with it, or move, hand it before he actually caught it. You know, moved his eye like a receiver does when he.
Just thinking about what he's got to do.
Yep, next.
Thinking about the next
step instead of getting the first step. And that's, you know, just
that's understandable. That's very understandable.
You see it all the time.
Fourth down and 20. Tarve in for the first punt for the Red Devils tonight. You're going to send number two back.
Bad deep. Snap. That's a good catch by
Tarve. High punt. Good coverage punt. Ball takes a bulldog bounce. Short punt. What was it, 18 yards, 20 yards? About 18-yard punt.
It was about about 28 longer than it could have been.
Oh, yeah.
Now, you talk about a hard thing to do, to catch a bad snap because you
want
to.
And think they coming anyway.
Oh, yeah, you want to grab it fast as you can and kick it off and looking at them, what's coming. But you got to concentrate on getting your hands on the ball first.
GMC gonna come back out with the shotgun. Full wide. Gonna send motion to the right. Pass picked off again by number, who is that, three, Deshaun Willis. And he's gonna score, I believe, Kenny.
Yeah, he is.
Touchdown, Red Devils. Pass interception, return for a touchdown, about a 40-yard return. Well, the Red Devils will take a commanding 27-0 lead with 10:13 left to go in the second quarter. Number 15, Jones, in there to do the snapping. Bo Reed, number 18, to set it down.
Me pulling you.
Low snap, good hold, Bo.
Uh-oh, did he hook it?
I believe it got in there, didn't it? No, they're going to say.
Now, if I had hands that were about 2 feet longer, I could have caught it.
I saw it come right by you, but.
Finally got you, Ernie.
How much inside was it?
Well, Greg, you see the Clark Hill rail sign over here to my right, your left?
Yeah.
Between me and the flagpole.
So, I thought from the angle we got, it looks like you ended.
No, I'm.
You're to the right of the. Post.
I'm to the right of the post. It went between me and the flagpole.
Yeah, I saw it go right by you, but I the angle we got, it looks like you on this side of it. Looked like you right behind the pole.
No. No, he's on the right on the corner of that, I guess his right, your left side, Greg, left side pole, my home side.
Red Devils, point after, fails. I tell you what, Bo was just lucky to get that thing up and get it set on the tee. It didn't roll back there, but it didn't like much of rolling back there.
Well, it was on the ground when he picked it up.
Yeah, it was on the ground. 10:13 left to go. 27-0 Red Devil lead.
Number
Talbot got it teed up to kick it off again.
Number 2 and number 28, I believe, look like deep.
High kick.
About the 10.
Gonna be taking
right.
It about the 12-yard line where number 2 fumbles it.
Uh-oh,
got a hole up the middle.
He got a hole, didn't he? Save it, Tarver.
Number 89, Tarver hits him at the 50.
And that saved the touchdown.
And that saved the touchdown. Finally dropped down by number 9, Stacey McClendon.
How many times have y'all seen in games, TV, high school, when that ball
when
is fumbled just a little bit?
The pursuit overrun.
Exactly. It just messes everything up.
First and 10, GMC ball going to be spotted on the Red Devil 37-yard line. With 10 minutes and 1 second left to go in the opening half. Boy, it'd be nice for the Red Devils to score one more time before the half.
Yeah, it would.
Maybe that clock would run. Handoff.
That's a loss.
Number 61, Ron L. Ferguson, kind of wrestles him down.
I'm looking for my
running back keeps leg drive moving, though, and he got about 2, maybe 3 yards. Going to bring up second down and long.
A little WWE action.
I'm looking for my Wilkinson Twigs contact. See if he got any more.
Keep calling that girl down there.
He just motioned to me, still 7-0. Have you got anything on that board yet, Layton?
They ain't posting nothing.
Did you post
ain't gonna
it?
Have nobody
I posted ours, but they
did
ain't.
Did you post theirs?
Well, I wouldn't.
Fake handoff.
I ain't going to post theirs because I don't know it to be true.
Well,
I don't want to put anything up there with my name that ain't true.
Well, there you go. Now, that's something to stand by. But I can tell you what, I have read a whole bunch of stuff in my life on the internet. And I read a whole bunch of stuff that wasn't true.
Can I get an amen?
Third down, about 8 to go. 8:48 left to go. Loss on the play that time with the little reverse by GMC.
Where in the world is our leader?
I wish I could tell you. GMC gonna come back out with the shotgun, 4 wide. We'll send motion to the left.
Uh-oh.
High snap.
They've been doing that all
that
night
ain't gonna
long.
Be good.
You know, they've been, uh-oh.
Red Devils.
Did they get the ball or us?
I believe they're gonna say it was down.
He was down.
Fourth down and a
bunch.
Pile here. About 23, 4 yards ago. Ball right on midfield. GMC will retain possession up until this punt.
Well, I imagine that ball's getting slick. It's cold out. It's cool out here.
It is. It's getting moist, ain't it?
It's nice in here now. We can't complain a bit about where we are. Good snap. And he punts it away again up in the stands. What's where they going to mark that at? That's got to be short.
There's a couple walking right there. It almost got him in the head.
What do you yell when that happens? 4 or 5 or here comes the football? Or, you know, like in golf, they always yell 4. What do they yell in football, Kenny?
Look out.
All right. I don't know. I'm just getting another update. 7-7, y'all. And I imagine it's about like our game in the first half.
Shotgun. 4 wideouts. Twiggs Wilkinson tied at 7. Red Devils got a commanding lead in this. Handoff around the right side, number 25, Middlebrooks. And if he breaks, I believe they're going to call number 6, Townsend, with a hold. Lucky they didn't get him with a shove out at the end of the play. Was it holding, Kenny?
Yeah.
I couldn't see it. It looked that way, but I couldn't. Holding against the Red Devils. That'll back us up 10.
Yeah, here's a, y'all, here's a classic example why Layton shouldn't post it. It's more than, Neil just said it was 7-6. And I guess whoever's calling Gene just thought they had told him touchdown and he'd seen 7-7. But if you remember, Neil said, you know, Tweeds don't go for, they don't kick extra points. It's going to be 7-6 or 7-8, one of the two.
Kenny, I don't want to correct you on the air, but that's Mike Frazier you're talking to.
Is that who I'm? Okay. Thank you.
I just wanted to get it straight for
you. First down and about.
Thank you.
Almost 15. Little crossbuck play in the backfield, kind of slow developing. Handed off to number 26 Green, and that'll get these GMC Bulldog fans something to cheer about as they stop him for no game.
It's three of them, ain't it? Mike, Gene, Barry.
I don't know, but
you made the test.
Well, I know, I know, I know those three.
Ernie, you watching me? Are you filming the game?
Somebody got to pay attention to you.
I just have
somebody needs to look after you if you had anything to do with these rosters we got. Hand off on the little crossbuck, number 27 Green, and that's slow developing. Your Fabian just didn't have anywhere to go. Loss on the play of about two. Now definitely a passing down. Third down at about 16, maybe 17.
Just under 6 minutes and a half.
Feel like we've been here 2 hours.
Yep. You feel like the game ought to be over, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Shotgun, three wide. Wide open, number 80, Josh Holloman. And he's going to be about 3, maybe 4 yards short of the first down. Going to bring up fourth down, and I thought he got further than that. Fourth down, about 5 to go where they spotted the ball. Tarver will come back out to boot it away again. 5:15 left. Red Devils up 27-0.
All right, good snap now.
On the Robbie Seymour scoreboard report.
Better snap.
Oh, my goodness. He blew that
wood up front.
Is that high and long?
Oh, what a hometown roll there.
It took a roll down dead at the 15-yard line where GMC will have it deep in their own territory.
It took a Buddy Buffett roll.
Yes, sir. With 4:51 left to go in the opening half. Red Devils up 27-0. Let's see if we can pick one more off here and go on and make it 30 here, going into half.
That is official on the post.
I back
Wilkerson County 7, Twig 6.
So you finally got somebody post. Oh, I thought he had face mask. He had it back his jersey.
They finally just got internet down there.
Well, I can tell you what they do got, Greg. Greg knows down at Layton and go. They got somebody that knows about a GHSA contract, don't they? Remember that question?
Yeah. Second down, 8 upcoming for GMC. Clock down at 4:18. Red Devils holding a 27-0 lead. Looks like everybody just may be going through the motion.
Everybody got their mind on
that other game
down south.
Drop back pass, number 7. Complete over there. Can't get a number.
I mean, people just don't understand that that means so much. It's like the incident you called the other day. What, 2 or 3 years we've won, 36 games or something like that?
And you lose one.
And you lose one.
And fall to third place.
I mean, it kills you.
I know.
You.
I told Greg, you count it back, Layton. You know, up to that game, counting that loss, we have only lost 2 games out of the last 36.
Well, you look at this, the thing it does on the county. You realize how much money comes into county when we have these home playoff games, when these stands is full And all that tax, you know, all that money coming in, helping that, you know, helping the county out. So it's a big deal.
First and 10, Bulldogs. Ball spotted on the 26-yard line. Handoff up the middle. Met by number 61, Ron L. Ferguson. Welcomes him to the Bud one more time. We'll bring up second down at about 10. He might have, oh, they going to finally push it up a little bit. Clock running, 3:21 left. Run, clock, run. Out backfield, two wideouts. Pass almost picked off by number 27, Jafavian Green. One I bet he wish he had over again. Stop the clock, 2:59 left.
Crowd's off a little bit too tonight, Greg, but it is
Red Devil's got a big crowd over there for the, well, I guess it come out for homecoming.
Yeah, it's a good night for football.
I would imagine midway through the third quarter, you'll see half that many over there. Third down, 10 to go.
Greg, my assistant is over here just in amazement looking at the size of 74, 72.
Handoff.
No
up
gain.
The middle. Maybe a gain of one. How's your assistant holding out, Kenny?
Oh, she's enjoying it. She's seeing it all. She likes it.
Fourth and long.
Nancy grinning from ear to ear.
Fourth and long. Punting situation for the Bulldogs. Looking over to the sideline like they may try a fake.
They ain't got to lose and everything to gain.
That's exactly right.
They good snap. Got off a good snap.
I tell you one thing, they practiced. They practiced putting that ball to the sidelines, didn't they?
Yeah, that looked like it took a duck hook left.
Looked like one I hit with a golf club.
They must have a problem with their special teams this year.
Well, they just don't want no touchdown returned on them. They dodged a bullet while ago when Alex picked that one up late. First and 10, Red Devils. Ball right dead on the 45. 2:11. Good time to bring out the two-minute offense here.
Yep.
And he's going to come out in the shotgun. Going to send two wides wide left. Got number 80 Holloman over here by himself on the right. Good snap. Quick throw over that number one, Wilkes. Goosby looking for a block.
Here he comes.
And
here
hey,
comes.
Run, Wilkes, run. Finally run out of bounds.
That's a
23-yard line.
22, right on it.
Well, it'll be first and 10, Red Devils. How far was that thing? Let's see, 45.
I mean, he got his
10.
Foot square in the middle of the hash mark of the 22.
That was about 32 yards on the pass play. Number 14, Goldman, to number one, Goosby. Got out of bounds, stopped the clock, 1:57. Got number 27, Green, out here wide right this time. Goldman. What they gonna call, Kenny? Holding?
I don't know. I was trying to pull me and my sister out of the way. That was close. It's obviously that's what it's gonna be. I don't know what else it could be. If you threw it down at the 22.
There he is, motioning right that dead in your face. What did he say? Was it holding?
I was trying to look for exactly where the marker was when he was signaling. He'll do it again. It's gonna be holding. Well, it could be. It could be a chop block. I don't think he did that.
Somebody done been to the Walmart.
It's 10 yards.
No, me.
Where'd he go? The one in
Holden?
I think he went to one in Marietta.
That's what I was going to say.
First down and 20. Maybe 21 or 22. Goldman in the shotgun set. Good, good timing.
That was a
short.
Good, you know, that's a good job of looking off, because he wanted to go over here on our
yep.
side.
Pass complete, number 27, Jafabian Green. Got some of the yards back, not many. Second down and about
17,
18.
18. But, I, you know, the more I look on the guy that's covering Wilk, the more I think that he could probably throw it up and Wilk could jump up there and get it.
Shotgun, four wides again.
Here,
which is wide.
Goes to the corner. Oh, a little high.
Pass goes right through the hands of number 80, Josh Holloman. Just a shade high, but a pass he still should have caught.
Yeah, I don't know how much more, how much yardage we'd have got. 5-6 maybe.
You would have been looking at third down at about 10.
Look, like Layton said, now is the time to lay it out over in this corner for Wills. Let him just fight for it.
Well, you got to send two. If you're going to throw it deep, you got to send two there together where if it's a tip drill.
Yeah.
You got somebody extra.
On y'all side, Wills, going over there. We got two over here, two greens. Oh, he's looking at Wills. Are you going to throw that swing to him?
And Wilkes can't get loose, and he takes a pretty good lick that time.
What they call that at Georgia, Greg? That pass play?
Swing pass. No, it ain't swing.
No.
It's something else they call it.
Thing where they cut a hit that thing.
It ain't a screen. They don't call it a screen, and they don't call it a swing. They call it
pass. It's a name they use for it. They use it at Georgia mostly.
Yeah, it's a funny name. Something you don't hear. It's kind of. It ain't belly pass.
No.
You call it a bubble screen some, too.
Yep, I've heard that.
But that ain't what they call it.
That ain't what they call it. Golly, I can't. Sometimes I believe I forget my own last name if somebody asked me.
I wouldn't be a bit surprised.
But you know how to sign in text forms, though, don't you?
I wish you would come look down here at the folks leading. Leading the homecoming parade here. Red Devils got it fourth down and 18, 47 seconds left.
No, we got two over here now, Greg, like you talked about, Wilkes and Green. They ain't one thing to do. Right here, there it is, here it comes. He got it.
He ain't gonna want to go back to the bench on that one.
He laid it right in
he
there.
He did. That was everything was perfect. Like he was delivering a baby.
It's just too perfect.
Yeah.
You know?
I mean, just right up in the.
You can't catch them all.
I believe Will's looking for that goal line, like talking about that punt a while ago. He was smelling the goal line.
GMC will take over on down, first and 10. Ball on their own 29-yard line, 40.7 seconds left to go. Good to see the Red Devils playing some different people in some different positions tonight.
We'll probably see a lot more of that in the second half.
Handoff straight up the middle. Kenny, you know we said early in the game, I see number 44, Daniel McAllister, standing over there on the side. He got up kind of slow.
Uh-huh.
Ain't nothing going on there, is it? I mean, he was in the game early, and now we see number 62, Garrett Matthews, in there playing.
I don't know, Greg. I'm already halfway around the other side. Clock running down.
Okay.
I'll ask Vernon when we come out. Second half. Yeah, I want to know.
Yeah, Ernie wants to know.
I don't think anything. I see that may be Neil Reed talking to him now. I mean, the radio folks don't look like they may be on top of things. But anyway, the end of the first half, Red Devils up 27 to nothing.
And we're going to head into halftime now. We're going to take a little break, and we'll be back in just a few minutes.
We'll take a halftime break and we'll be back right after this.
Welcome back, fans. We're here at the second half of this ball game between the Lincoln County Red Devils and the GMC Bulldogs. As we're getting underway here with the kickoff in the second half, Lincoln County on top, 27-0. Greg?
It rolls out of bounds. So far, that's one thing you can say about GMC kicking game. They have tried to kick it out of bounds every time.
Greg, you got a score update for us, don't you?
Yeah, we got a halftime score to Wilkerson County Twigs game. Wilkerson County 13, Twigs 6. That's who we're pulling for, too, Wilkerson.
Looks like we're going to make them re-kick.
Yep,
they kicked
I would say so.
What happened, Murray?
They kicked it out
of bounds. They kicked it out of bounds. It's going to come back again now.
The official will figure out which ball they want to use.
They're going to use one brown pointed on both ends, I bet, ain't they? Go back them up 5. I thought that was a 10-yard penalty. I guess it's just 5, though. Go back them up to the 35, where he's got it set to address it again. And he kicks it the other way. Caught by number 5, Jatorius Jones, at his 22-yard line. He returns back up in the middle
over
of the field.
Over here, he's got
if he breaks to the outside, it ain't going to be no good. Come out. He knocked 2 of them down, whoever it was. That was another lick.
Look.
What did he run back in the middle of the field
this
for?
This was him by Middlebrook. Did y'all see him?
I saw human bodies flying, but I couldn't tell
those
who
it was. You saw was Middlebrook.
He done got tired of getting hit, ain't he, kid?
20 yards apart now.
He done started giving it back. He done started giving it back to him. First and 10, Red Devils. Ball on about the 12-yard line, I think. Nope, by about the 17. Well, it'll be first and 10, Red Devils. Kenny, you need to ask somebody if the clock going to run when they score this touchdown. Double wing set, handoff, number 25, Middlebrooks, bounces to the outside.
Oh my goodness.
Did he run over?
My goodness.
I couldn't, it was people in the way. I couldn't see it, Kenny. Did he run over?
Did he run over? Look, you got to watch the video of that. You got to get my video of that.
Ernie, did you see that? Did you catch it? Were you able to catch it?
I got it on the video.
Oh, my goodness. It looked exactly
Herschel like Walker.
Herschel Walker running over Bill Bates. No doubt about it. Look, I got these headsets on, and I heard it.
Touchdown, Red Devils. 11:31 left to go in the third quarter. Snap count of behind Bo Reed. Kicked right through that. Run the score to 34-0 with 11:31 left to go in the third quarter. So the Red Devils come out on about a 60-yard kickoff return.
I'm on the side that we scored. I don't know where
he caught
it.
About 60 yards with number 5, Jones, returned it.
Greg, while we're getting ready for the Red Devils kickoff, we want to thank some of the people who helped make this broadcast possible. We want to thank Verizon Wireless Radio Shack. We want to thank Wilkes Telephone and NewZ.com for all the support they give us. We want to thank some more people y'all are not telling me about.
Wingrove, Providence Fair, Kenny and Roy.
Yeah,
while
we're talking about Providence Fair, Kenny Jeffco is in the hospital. Y'all
yep,
talking about
already
that.
Talked about that.
And we want to remember him in our prayers.
Tarver's got it set on the 40-yard line to kick it off to GMC one more time.
Trying to get Dr. Williams off the field, looks like. That referee's hollering, running, trying to get him back.
Ball taken at about the 12-yard line by number 2, and wow, what a lick by number 85, G. Ellen. He hurt himself going on that one.
Greg, I need to thank Clark Hill Reynolds, who've donated the Iron Sky for all the
game. Want to thank Clark Hill Reynolds, Mike Beggs, and
Hawes Reed.
Hawes Reed. There we see Ernie Doss, our eye in the sky. And not only is he our eye in the sky, he's the eye in the sky for the team as well.
Eye backfield, three wide out set, two right, one left. Nanny gonna stop it before we ever get started.
I don't know what they're doing. They're getting it set and ready.
Surely they're gonna tell them to let the clock run. Handoff straight up the middle.
About
number 61, Ronnell Ferguson. Number four.
They threw a flag.
Houston Wynn. Number 72 to Travis Harrison now. And I believe they're going to get Lincoln County for unsportsmanlike conduct. And that'll be another first down for GMC. Gonna be 15 yards on a first down. Ball gonna be out close to the 40. He's finally gonna set it down at the 43 yard line where GMC will have it first and 10 on their own 43. Red Devils up 34 to nothing. Clock running, 11:04. Shotgun, four wide outs.
You hear that?
Yep.
PA just announced it. 21, baby.
21-6. Wilkerson over Twiggs in the third quarter. Second down, 10 to go.
Now, what are we going to send down to Wilkerson to the school? A fruit basket.
Oh, yeah.
I heard we're sending eye in the sky.
I say we sent them some black-eyed peas.
And some Rotel and some of that Miss Tammy's enchilada. What
man,
you call it, Greg?
Good.
Enchilada dip. Handoff, number six.
Wasn't nobody on run? Oh, we got another flag. Throwing in all the way from over here at the sideline.
Gain of two.
He saw.
Holding.
Face mask.
Face mask on the Red Devils.
Face mask on the Red Devils.
Clock still running, evidently. They sent a message up there and told them, please let it run.
Please, Mr. Please.
Another big 15-yarder. That was an aggressive face mask penalty there. Ball all the way down to the Red Devil 40-yard line. What GMC will have it. First and 10. I think they've made two first downs on their own and got three by virtue of penalties. Wide out wide each side. Eye backfield behind the quarterback. Handoff last man through. And he is drugged down by number 61, Ronnell Ferguson. Number 40, Tony Wells in there with some help as well. Loss of about four on the play. Gonna bring up second down, 14. This is the kind of defense we like to see the Red Devils play. You know, it's still, you gotta think, it still ain't quite the showing you'd like to see them come out with right in the beginning after a bit of defeat like we took last week. Shotgun, four wideouts, 8:37 left on the clock. Heavy pressure, pass complete, gonna be good for about 6, maybe 7 yards. Gonna bring up third down and about 8. I believe they finally let the clock roll. They ain't stopped it enough.
Yeah, they were letting it roll during the penalty.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I saw them letting it roll during the penalty. They finally must have sent word to them. Shotgun, four wides. Good snap, heavy pressure. Number 61, Ferguson, will sack him back at about the 48-yard line.
He went down by himself, didn't he, Greg?
No, Ronnell had him by the collar. Fourth down and 20. Let's see where he punts it out of bounds through this time.
Usually been kicking it to the far side. Looks like he's going to kick it over to the home side is where it's the hash mark.
Good snap.
No, kick it the other way. He kicked his slam over the fence. Didn't he hit somebody?
Well, he kicked it.
Did you see him hit that guy?
I thought he kicked it. Did it hit the guy? I thought he hit the fence.
He hit him right in the leg.
Red Devils take over first and 10. Ball on their own 26-yard line. 7:06 left to go in the third quarter. Got a new quarterback in town. Bo Reed will take over.
Still got Wilkes in there.
See if he'll throw one out there to Wilkes. They've been throwing the ball since they was old enough to walk.
This is a good time to do it, just between now and end of the game. Let him get some
hand off
work.
One of the greens, I believe. I believe that was the number.
I think it's 26.
Yeah, number 26, Jamarion Green. Run, clock, run.
Ain't going fast enough, is it, Greg?
Nope.
No, Layton's back.
Yeah, I'm back.
Yeah, he wanted to go see what Bruce got at Walmart.
And Sam's and Walgreens and Bales and...
Handoff around the left side, number 12, Alex Ellis. Breaks loose, gets close to a first down. I believe he's going to be about a yard short. Butch got him set down about 2 yards short. Going to be third and two. Clock down to 6 minutes. Red Devil still holding a commanding 34-0 lead. Bruce, you got to announce the homecoming queen and princess. We ain't done that yet.
All right, somebody jumped.
I believe it's going to be offsides on the defense.
Yep.
The homecoming queen was Kitty Ball, I believe, right?
And the princess was Madison Sagas.
Madison Sagas.
Want to congratulate both of those young ladies on the 2007 homecoming court.
And all of the homecoming court. We had a lot of fine-looking young ladies out there.
Yeah, it was a beautiful homecoming court.
All very deserving.
First and 10 after the offside penalty. Reed still in that quarterback. Got a little double wing set. Going to send motion. Hand off to number 3 in motion to Shane Willis.
Ooh.
And he gets about 8. Going to be second down and 2.
He was a standing still target.
That's what I was going to say.
Yep.
Letting
you got to get out.
A standing duck, wasn't he?
Yep. You got to get out on a deal like that.
I'll run out of bounds one.
He was coming at him from the backside full speed.
Clock down to 4:28. Second down, 2. Handoff, number 26. The first down and more. Gain of about 8 on the play, maybe 9, where it'll be 1st and 10 in the Bulldog territory. Ball will be spotted at the 44-yard line. Run, clock, run.
How about some names on some fresh linemen there, Greg? We got 60 and 70 and...
70, Michael Newman's been in there all night.
Okay.
Number 62, Garrett Matthews, has been playing defense.
All right, y'all. Here we go again.
Handoff, number 12, Alex Ellis. Bo Reed doing a good job in there with the misdirection handoff.
We got the score to work in the game somewhat close. between the three sources. They, you know, announced it on the PA 21, but Vernon said somebody said the name. I forget it's down there. You call him, and it's 19-6.
19-6.
That's what Vernon just told me. Talk, somebody just down.
Well, long as Twiggs don't get no more than 6, yeah, we in good shape.
Yeah, that 6 been hanging in there.
Yep. Second down to 4 to go. Handoff, man in motion number 3 to Shane Willis. He dances around. Has enough for the first down. Down inside the 30 at about the 28, where it'll be first and 10, Red Devils. Clock still running. 2:37 left to go. Red Devils up 34 to nothing.
That started to look like one of them Darrell Norman runs from last year, where he run a touchdown all the way from one side and he cut back all the way over the other corner.
Yeah, you know, Darrell, I hadn't talked to anybody here lately, but at the beginning of the season, you know, he was at, went to UAB this year.
Did he?
And he's getting some playing time.
Is he the one y'all call Butch?
No, that Butch
was
that? Number 8.
Okay.
Darrell was number 7.
Right, I know what number, I didn't know which one y'all called Butch.
And number 12, Alex Ellis, drugged down by number 25. What did he get, about 5?
Let's see.
Not quite 5, got about 4.
Greg, they post on the computer over here, they got Wilkinson County 21, Twig 6. That's what they posted on the computer over here, so
they still posting 21-6?
They just posted it.
Again.
It sounds maybe the same source that, who knows.
Long as Twigs don't get no more than 6, and the other side is close to right. Number 3, Willis again.
He's about a yard short.
What'd he get out? Right at the 20, about the 21.
21. 20 and a half. 21.
Third down, 2 to go.
He's just outside the 21. He's in between the 21 and 22.
Clock going to be down under a minute. Snapping of the ball. Number 65, Daniel Morris going out. Let's see who took his place. Number 52 of the Red Devils, DJ Bradshaw.
False start against the Red Devils.
Yeah,
how was that a false start?
It was something in the backfield.
It don't make any difference. One man can be moving.
Well,
they had two moving. They had two in motion.
You want to come down here and argue with him?
I see Coach chewing on somebody. I saw number 12, Alex Ellis, go in motion, but that's the only one I saw to win in motion.
Did we have a wing on your side? Whoever was on your side moved too.
Yeah, it was two moving.
Yeah.
I didn't see but one. That's back them up 5, be third down about 6.5, maybe 7.
40, 39 seconds left and a half.
Same set again. Bo gonna drop back and pass it.
Oh,
pass
right.
Complete,
hoodie,
number 26.
Hoodie pass.
Good job, Bo Reed.
About the 5, looks like about the 5. Let's see where he's gonna put him. Now he's gonna put him at
number
the
18,
seven.
Reed completes
seven.
It to number
seven
26,
yards,
Green. Good for the first down. Where they spotted at the 7, Kenny?
Yeah, right at the 7.
Well, it'll be first and goal, Red Devils. Be the last play of the third quarter. The clock will expire right here. Red Devils up 34 to nothing.
Boots, I got a new fan we can go to here between the quarters. Down at the end of the field we on now.
Hold on a minute.
We got a special guest.
With us right now, we got Ken Vance from, he's the chairman of Georgia Post Council. Honored to be here. Glad to have you. How was your trip down? How was your trip up today?
Oh, it's beautiful. Thank you. Well, anybody that comes, this is high school football, folks. This is the prettiest field I've ever seen.
We appreciate that. Tell everybody at home a little bit about the job that you do for the state of Georgia and what it pray tells.
What it amounts to is if you wear a badge in Georgia, you have to be certified by the state. And the office that the governor appointed me to controls the certification and the training and the investigation of officers that do wrong. So there's a good bit to it. There's 55,000 law enforcement officers in the state of Georgia and 1,050 agencies. So we have enough to do.
And it's not just deputies, it's communications officers like myself that run 911. It's corrections officers that work for the prison system in the state of Georgia, parole officers,
GBI, state
GBI,
patrol,
everything.
Local deputies, I mean, correctional folks. It runs the whole gamut.
Any law enforcement in the state of Georgia?
Yes, sir.
All right, Layton, you talked enough about all that. Now, we want to know what Ken thinks about the game so far.
Would y'all please give us some points? It's 34 zip. These boys are about averaging about 6 points a game. We'd like to get those six as soon as possible.
Okay. Well, they're playing their hearts out. We'll say that for them.
They are. They're a good team. They just don't have any speed, to be honest with you.
Well, Ken, we appreciate you being here with us tonight. Great to have you in the booth with us.
Thank you.
You have a
safe trip home, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
What we did? What was that? What happened, Greg?
Red Devils go in on a touchdown run, number two. On the carry. I believe it was number two. What?
Number two. Looked like a little off tackle.
11:42 left to go. Red Devils up 40-0. High snap. Vance hooks it in now. Bo had to reach around behind him to pull that one down.
Bo does a good job.
Bo has done it. Bo has had a good ball game tonight.
A ball game in, a ball game out. Bo's had a good game, a good season holding the ball for us. As well as coming in there for quarterback tonight.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
He's done a good
job
tonight, I can tell you what. We're proud of Bo.
Like Kenny said, when Austin had his chin strap broke, I mean, when you're standing there, you always got to be ready to go in.
Yep, I think Bruce missed that. He was.
Yep, you always got to be ready to go in, but when they call you, you just ain't quite ready.
Yep, and Kenny, I don't know where you at.
I'm on the 25-yard line over here at the Senate Field, the 25. I think you're looking at me now.
But you got a special guest.
Yeah, I got a guest with me tonight.
Are you on? Which 25 are you on?
I'm on the Lincoln, where our team is lined up. He's close to me, Bruce.
Okay, I got you now.
I got my niece here with us tonight. This is her first Red Devil game, and she's been outfitted in a Red Devil outfit, and she loves football. She's 10 years old.
All right, we're great. Great to have her here tonight, and the game's back underway.
Big kick by Tarver, taken down about the 2-yard line.
Tripped up.
Up short of the 20 at about the 18.
Number 80.
I'm just going to ask you a quick question. Amber, what you think about your first Red Devil game?
I think that they're playing really good tonight.
Well, good. You enjoying your first game up here?
Yes, sir.
Because you really love football, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
All right, we're glad to have her here and cheering these Red Devils on.
It ain't never too late to get started watching Red Devil football, is it?
No, it's not.
We got a score here, Greg. Wilkerson County 19, Twiggs County 12.
They done corrected it, huh?
19-12. Mm.
And they're still in the third quarter.
Our backfield, two wideouts. Handoff goes off tackle. Gain of about one. Gonna be second down, long to go. Run, clock, run. Ten 20 left to go. Red Devils up 41-0. Like he said, GMC is a good-looking team, but they are definitely in a rebuilding year. I'm sure they work hard and they play hard. I know they hadn't give up here. Handoff off tackle. Number 85, Giella, making contact in the backfield. Running back kind of squirms away a little bit. Gain of about three, going to be third down, five to go.
And Bruce, we want to add too with our special guest. We want to, the person that made it possible for him to be up here, Mr. Walker T. Norman, Chairman of County Commissioners of Lake County. We want to thank him for everything he does for us through the year and everything.
Yeah, we appreciate all the fine support we get from the Iowa County Commissioners in helping us bring these ball games to you each week.
Number 33, Stephen Morris in that linebacker, along with number 63, Walker. Pass wide open.
Oh, good catch.
Is he inbounds? Yeah.
Yeah, he's inbounds out across the 40, about the 43-yard line, 43 and a half. Well, it'll be first to 10. Red Devils getting a lot of fresh shirts in there. First and 10 Bulldogs. Shotgun, four wides. Good snap. Good play over there by number 15. Jones, I believe that's the long snapper, isn't it?
It is.
Also playing in the secondary. Broke on the ball and knocked it down just before it got to the receiver. Clock running down to 8:06 and counting. Shotgun, four wides again. Good snap. Good protection.
Intercepted
by number 8, Frank Sherman.
He's still on his feet.
Still on his feet. Rambling down inside the 20. Finally drug down at about the 16 or the 17-yard line. Number 8, Franklin Sherman.
Good return by Sherman.
Well, the Red Devils will take over first and 10. Ball's going to be at the 17. Clock still running. Count on down, 7:10 left to go. Red Devils up 41-0. Getting late here in the fourth quarter. At the Bud.
Greg, you know this is almost like the basketball score yesterday with Washington Wilson, Lincoln County, and the girl on the girls' side.
How did the boys do?
You know, I don't know. They were winning when I left.
Handoff, number 87, off tackle, and he may go in. Finally drug down from behind. Number 87 is Harrison.
Greg, I don't know if you know, but number 8 is in his quarterback.
I didn't even see. I see him going to get the play now.
Is that who just intercepted the pass?
Yeah, number 8, Franklin Sherman, now in at quarterback.
That's where we got an eye in the sky, isn't it, Greg?
It's hard to know. I'm pretty good at noticing, but it's hard to notice everything. He'll drop back to pass this time.
Ooh, he could have went the other way with that.
Yep. Could have been intercepted. Pass, it probably should have been intercepted, but.
Well, there were three right there on it.
Yep.
I wanted to say while we had a second, speaking of alternates and talking about our Cheer Devils, as you said earlier, the Cheer Devils had some injuries, and they were able to put new people in and actually do their routine without any deductions. It just wasn't enough for this round.
Yeah, we're really proud of our Cheer Devils. They've done a great job.
They work hard all year. You can't say enough about them. Number 9, drug down just short of the goal line. Looks like maybe about the 2.
Right on the 2.
Station McClendon.
I walk over here on this side with the surveying crew.
And that's a first down. First and goal.
To add to what Ernie said, you know, the Cheer Devils, they cheer every Friday night, but that's just a small part of what they do. They practice hard, and they go to competition, and unfortunately, they came up a little short, but they did a great job, and we're very proud of them.
Touchdown. Number 2.
Number two is Josh Sims going in for the touchdown. That'll run the score to 47-0. Now, why don't the clock keep running that, Kenny?
I think it stops on touchdowns after and change of possessions and penalties only. Maybe not penalties. Change of possession and after touchdown.
449 left to go. High snap. Bo gets it down. Vance kicks it through. That'll run the score to 48 for the Red Devils. GMC still scoreless.
And I'm going to tell you,
we need to score that ball game, what we need.
Our band is really sounding good.
Did Layton turn on Johnny's website? Sound like he, I hear, oh, that's the real band playing it, okay.
No, that's the real band. And they have done a terrific job tonight, as they've done all season long. And they do a great job supporting our team, keeping them fired up. That music really helps out, Kenny. I don't know what about, I mean.
I wish you'd go over there and get one more true score before you come back up here.
Well, who would be your true source?
I thought
which
you
one you want me to choose?
You were talking to Mike Frazier earlier. You got to dance with the one that brought you.
I think Vernon was the one that corrected the first time.
Well, that, I mean, just somebody.
There you go.
You're just trying to get one more in on me, ain't you, Greg?
What'd you say, girl? You got to dance with the one that brought you.
That's right. It don't make no difference. Just give us a score.
19-6.
Number 89, Tarver. Got it teed up. High booming kickoff down at about the 4-yard line.
Uh-oh.
Hole up the middle.
And he said he didn't have no speed. That was a little speed there, wasn't it?
That was some speed there.
I tell you what, how many times have we seen number 89, Tarver, save a touchdown? Held him up just long enough for number 34, Anthony, to get that to help out.
Well, Tarver ain't your regular size kicker. I mean, he can lay a lick on you, too. He ain't small.
He's aggressive, isn't he?
He's aggressive. He ain't small by no means.
Clock down at 4:23. GMC got the ball on the Red Devil side of the field at the 42-yard line. Handoff, last man through, met by number 33, Stephen Morris. Gain of about two, gonna bring up second down, 8. Clock under 4 minutes to go. Red Devil's still up 48 to nothing. I tell you what, the Red Devil side over there is clearing out a little bit, but I'm going to tell you something about this GMC crowd. They come here with them, they're going to stay with them, mate.
They're staying here.
Second down, 8. Wide out to each side.
Oh, got a fumble.
Delay.
He's still out there.
Ball recovered by the GMC Bulldogs. Back on the Red Devil side of the field at about the 47, maybe 48-yard line.
That ball was kicked back there, wasn't it, Greg?
It was.
All right, I got
it. Had a little delay.
I got your answer, Greg.
What is it?
You ain't going to like it. 19-12 with 5 minutes to go in the third.
Five to go in the third.
So it sounds like it's dogfight on. Can we get on Google Earth and see any of it, Bruce?
We can give it a try. Surely somebody lets us know
something. As much technology as Ernie Dawson's got, he ought to be to get some kind of, maybe we can call
drug down from behind by number 42 of the Red Devils, Smith.
Tie in one of them spy satellites or something.
Fourth down at about 16, clock down to 2:17 and running slowly. Red Devil still up 48 to nothing.
Greg, we'll do that in a minute.
Clock down under 2 minutes now. GMC still looking at about a fourth down at 16. Line up in shotgun, gonna send motion to the right. Good snap, good protection. Pass knocked down by number 33, Stephen Morris.
Stephen Wildman Morris.
Red Devils will take over first and 10. on their own side of the 50 at about the 49-yard line. Well, I'm sure they'll be content to take a knee.
Well, looks like I was wrong on change of position because it ain't stopped on that.
I think they just stop it whenever they want to stop it.
Touchdowns and timeouts. That's it. I knew it was two things.
Number 8, Sherman, still in there. He's going to line up in the shotgun with four wides and see what he can do with it here. Quick pass out to number 9.
Ooh.
And he squirts away.
He might score. No.
Surely not.
Still.
Down inside the 15 to about, looks like about the 12.
There's going to be a flag on that, too.
Yeah, it is.
Cheerleaders odd, ain't it, Ernie? I'm on the other end. They knocked out right at the end, wasn't he?
Well, there's two flags. There's one in the middle of the field about the...
About the 40, about the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, the 35, and then there's that one where he went out of bounds.
It looked like a possible late
hit. Ain't you got one right here at the line of scrimmage, too, at about the 47-yard line? Ain't that one right up?
I think that rag's been out there all night, Greg. I don't know what that is.
Yeah, I don't think that's a flag. Because he's covering the one on the 35 or 32.
Yeah, I see him right there. That's the one they standing over is on about the 28, 27.
You know what? It's 48 to nothing, and it's 46.9 seconds left. Just call it all.
They got an unsportsmanlike on GMC and something on the Red Devils. They going to offset, I'm sure. Just start the clock back with 46.9 seconds left. Red Devils up 48 to nothing. Let him take a knee, coach. They got to get back to Millersville in time to eat at the brick, ain't they?
Yeah, I tell you what.
What's that other place we ate at down at that sandwich shop?
Was it the Miller Mushroom or something?
No. I can't call it. It's a little pizza place right down on the right going into town.
Oh,
if you ever get down out of Millersville, stop in there and get you a... What was that chicken sandwich we had?
Yeah,
wasn't
it was good,
it was
too.
So good.
Yeah, Tammy liked it, didn't she?
Tammy wasn't with us on
Tammy
that trip.
Tammy didn't go with us on that trip.
Oh, I thought you were talking about that chicken sandwich.
No, that's when we went to Chick-fil-A three or four years ago, yeah.
I don't know who it was running late.
I don't know, but we had all the stuff. Number 8, Sherman will take a knee at the 25-yard line. He got to do it one more time, and that'll be the seal of the deal. Red Devils up 48 to nothing. Looking to take one more.
They'll do it again. They just set the clock. 22 seconds, so I don't believe they have to do another one. That's it. Officials just told them, I think, they don't want
to. Yep, that'll be the final play of the ball game. Clock down to 12 seconds. Red Devils up 48 to nothing, so that'll do it, Bruce.
Let's go finish the regular season now.
We just got to wait and see.
Down, 3, 2, 1. And Lincoln County comes out on top, 48-0, over the GMC Bulldogs.
We see our teams out there
exchanging congratulations in a sportsmanlike manner, and that's always great to see. It's been a good ball game played by both of these teams tonight here, and we always like to see good sportsmanship.
Red Devils just a little better than GMC tonight.
Lincoln County fortunately coming out on top.
Waiting to hear the outcome of that Wilkinson County Twigs game. What's the last score we heard?
19-12 is all we got.
19-12.
Or 21-12, whichever one you want to like better.
In the middle of the third quarter, kind of probably to the end of the third now. But
they're probably wrapping up the third quarter.
So by the time you see this on TV, you'll probably know who won.
Yep. And we'll be either joining you from Lincoln County at Buddy Buffett Field or out there somewhere.
Or up in Atlanta. Depending on where we play, finish first, we'll be right here at the beautiful Bud.
I hope so.
If we finish third, it ain't going to be good.
Ain't nothing good going to come out of it.
Y'all listen up. I got one thing from the middle of the field out here. Let's get us a little interview. This is a good time. Last game of the season.
Where are you,
Kenny? I'm right here in the middle of the field.
Wave an arm, Kenny Adair.
What line are you on?
Right here on the 42.
He's on the 42. That's not the middle.
Quarterback Austin Goldman. Hold on a second.
Good job tonight, Austin.
Hey, appreciate it.
Great game, great game.
Great season, great regular season.
Yeah, appreciate it. Yeah, we got another season ahead of us now.
Yeah, we do. Depending on, it's sad to say, but we got to sit back and wait on the outcome of another game to see whether we got to put new tires on the car or either come back to town to play.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, Austin, you've had a great season all year long, and we appreciate the fine job you've done for the Red Devils.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
And we're looking forward to the playoffs now.
Yep, me too.
All right.
Season ahead of us.
Well, go home and get you a good night's rest and get ready for practice next week, because we'll need it wherever we go.
All right, I will.
All right.
Okay. All right, we'll see y'all.
All right, Stone Cold. Thank you.
All right, we'll see you, man. Bye.
All right, Kenny.
All right.
All right, Kenny, we appreciate you and your assistant helping us out tonight.
All right. She had a good time.
And we're glad she came.
And
we hope she's going to come back again.
Red Devil.
Hope she'll be back again.
Oh, yeah.
All right, Lincoln County coming out on top here at Buddy Buffett Stadium, 48-0. Go ahead, Greg.
We got to thank them sponsors. Go ahead.
We want to thank everybody that helped make this broadcast possible. We want to thank Clips. We want to thank Comcast. We want to thank Fifth. We want to thank Dicom and UZ for this fast, fast internet service they provide us here, the DSL at Buddy Buffett Stadium. And it's coming to you soon. Sooner than you think.
All over the
closer
county.
Closer every day. All over everywhere. We're closer than we've ever been. That's what we always like to say, right?
Closer than we ever been.
All right, we want to thank Verizon Wireless Radio Shack. We want to thank Wingroves. We want to thank Providence Ferry and use...
Kenny and Roy Jeffco.
Kenny and Roy Jeffco and
Greg Smith.
Creative Communities. And we want to send our prayers
out. Is it Greg Smith or Jeff Smith? Which is
Greg Smith.
I thought I had it right.
You did. I was laughing at
late.
You.
I busted out laughing.
I was laughing at Bruce looking at you trying to get all the ounces.
We want to send our prayers out to Kenny Jeffco.
Yep.
He had surgery recently.
He's a good guy.
And he's a great guy. He's been a great supporter of Lincoln County Red Devil football.
Couldn't do it without him.
If everybody don't know, he's the one who's responsible for getting radio here for us a couple of years
ago
for the big state championship.
That's right. So we want everybody to remember him in their prayers. And we want to thank the Jeffco family for all the support they've given us. Who else we got to thank, Greg?
I'm drawing a blank.
Okay, well, if we left you out, we're sorry. We thank you.
If you'll send us a note, we'll get you next time.
Yeah, send us a bigger check next time. We'll remember you. Okay? All right. If nothing else, Lincoln County on top here at Buddy Buffett Stadium over the GMC Bulldogs, 48-0. Where we'll be next week, we don't know right now.
Go Wilkerson.
Go Wilkerson. So, for Kenny Adair, Greg Norman, Layton Taylor, Jill McKinney, Ernie Doss,
Amber Garrett.
This is Bruce Beggs saying good evening and
go Devils! Woo!
Reason everybody should be shaking at the house tonight.
You should grab your favorite lady and pass her to the right.
Well, tell my guy to come back and give me a shot of some good food,
so we can party to some Stomp Down, butt bumping, rock and roll, rhythm and blues.
The boys are back in town. The boys are
doing it on the phone.
Jump up and down, turn around, tell the band to play some more.
'Cause tonight you can dance and romance and do anything you feel like doing. Hey, don't be surprised, 'cause you know what I like. Tonight